Hi everyone. Today we are going to talk about how we can incorporate pleats and godet in a torso dress pattern. And I'm using Prince's panel pattern, or you can say a drafting method, to explain godet and box pleat. You can also incorporate godet and box pleat in a shift or a sheet or a box, depending upon the design or the pattern you want to create by adding these. The first thing I want to talk about that I would initially would like you to work upon panel variations rather anything else. So see how you can incorporate more godets or more pleats in different ways to incorporate this. So for this right now, for the blocking of this, I'm not going to tell you how I have blocked it, because I have used the same pattern given to you in your Prince's panel. Okay, and I am assuming that you guys can start using your brain in terms of how wide you can take, because the width is completely dependent upon the kind of flare you would want to go for. Okay, and even the side panel you are going to take, thinking that how post side seam, how you are adding flare and how much you want. Coming down onto the a box pleat pattern, I will explain you what I have done in this. Okay, so I have taken only one single box pleat over here, for which I have draped from, so this is my hip line. So this is the hip line and this is the waistline. If you guys have succeeded making the Prince's basic dress, in which we are coming down till here and we are dropping a flare from this point, and then doing the same thing over here on the side seam panel. I have also done the same thing, it's just that I have incorporated and added pleats in within this, and I have taken the width of the scale as a pleat area over here to give it a pleat depth with the side seam allowance. So from here, to here till hip level, I have taken my markings, and after this I have removed my panel from the dress form and I have done the markings over on the flat. I have dropped it from this point, which is my hip point. I have taken 1/4 inch over here as an ease, okay, and I have blended this ease from here and dropped it, okay, and then I have dropped it straight, extended this line, and I have made pleats over here. How is it gonna look and how is it gonna pin is going to be one thing which I will be talking here about. Okay, first we will overlap these two seams on the either sides. Okay, this is a side seam panel, so in this side seam panel I need to have a pleat over here, and I also wanted to have a pleat on the side seam as well, so I have also included over here. Now depending upon the design, if you want to add the pleat on the side seam, it's up to you. If you don't, you can skip that. Again, everything will be dependent upon the design and the variation. And I would appreciate that if you are trying more variations with the basics, because that's how it will help you to develop further in this. So I'm going to start with the pleat, the pinning of this, and I'll show you how we have pinned all this way, and we'll show you the final end product. The same thing I have also done over here in a godet panel. I have I have draped my entire panel straight over here, the sightseeing panel straight. Okay, I have taken my ease marks over here and then extended and blended this line till the dropping hem. From here, I have taken a marking of the length from here. I have measured this part from my hip to hem. This is the measurement I have taken from hip to hem, which is 13 inches. I have marked my 13 inch line over here, from here to here. Okay, and then I have seen that how much flare and the godet flare I want to take, which is 3 inches on the either side in a basic pattern I'm taking. And then I have taken seam allowances and I have joined this part. So you will get this trapezium sort of a thing shape over here, which is going to match. Now, one more thing I have done. I have also measured from this point to this point, which is the center line. Then I have taken the same measurement over here. Okay. Which is why I have a curved hem, because this is also 13 and this is also 13. Which is why I am having curved hem, and which is why when I will be pinning this part from here, it is going to match from end to end. Alright, so you need to take care, you already know a lot of this from the basic, and I don't think so it's very difficult to absorb further, to drape around and to try and explore around, because our foundation pattern is the same. It's just that we need to see how are we going to variate and how are we going to use it further. So I'm going to be pinning the godet pattern and the pleat pattern, and I'll show you how it looks on the form. And if you can see, the pleats are also opening over here. It has gone, the center seam has gone inside. Your side seam is also inside, aligned the same way over here. Okay. Now, if you see, this is how a godet dress looks like. I have only draped front in this to give you a look at how this falls. Okay. And you can also add it over here and over here, and then you can also do more panels with more godets, you will get more coins. Now I'll be talking about mitered stripes. In this particular section, I will talk to you about mitering of stripes. So mitering of stripes means when you are making your pattern so close that your stripes on a fitted seams like this are matching line to line from this to this, this to this. It's one of the very interesting techniques and method to make a very high fashion quality garment, and it's one of the most important aspects of a good quality product is when checks or stripes are being made are to be put in a panel in such a way that it doesn't look like there is a seam running in the middle, because everything seems flawless, mitered. Mitered means matched line to line closely, however you can, and at very few areas, because this is the highest contour area, somewhere there can be a little bit of a shift of the line, but in maximum area, maximum portion, it is being matched. The only way you can actually match it pretty well is through the notch marks. So notch marks are pretty important in a pattern. This is a basic dress pattern, and if you see, I have put my lines right now. I've placed this pattern on a cross grain because I want to show how we can miter the best in this, in a because my lines are in a lengthwise grain, and I want to put it in a crosswise in this pattern. Okay, so technically this is a lengthwise grain. I would have put it ideally like this, but let's say in my design I want to do horizontal stripes, not vertical stripes. So how am I going to go about it? I'm going to place it crosswise, maintaining the grain line direction. Okay, make sure your pattern is lying straight in this case. Your notch marks are matching every point over here, so that the moment you cut this entire strip, your line, your notches are going to make you help match the line. Okay, so always align the pattern like this and then cut it into parts. If this is cut to or on fold, then you need to put this on fold and then cut this. If this is cut to, then again you need to layer two layers underneath and then cut this panel. Always make sure before cutting this, you need to make a pattern first. I am right now showing you in this how I have placed my test fit over here. So the one problem, if you are going to trace the test fit, the moment you're going to run your tracing wheel, the fabric trying to move or shift, or it's not going to give you an actual pattern shape. So the best way is that the moment you are done with this fabric, transfer this onto a paper pattern, and your paper pattern should not have seam allowance. Second thing. Third thing will be that once you will place it over here with the notch marks, you will get accurate points and matching lines. Okay, so try this out. This is going to be your new assignment in terms of mitering the pattern which you are thinking, in which you have to use stripes and you have to see how are you going to miter it well on the seams. Okay, thank you. So now if you see, this is how we have completed our mitered stripes on this fabric, and I have again used the box pleat pattern in this, and this is how closely you can see that these stripes should match. All right, so try this one and let me know. Thank you.